Smut cave.
All right, I'm gonna start it up now. Turn on this screen. Okay, so there we are. It is the year 2020. We are back again, somehow, some way, with the Smut Cave, albeit in a unusual format. This is the first time we're doing a telepresent interview. Ladies and gentlemen, here via Zoom call, Simon Hanselmann.
Hello, Spelunka. Thank you for having me.
Thank you for being here, Simon. How's it going in Seattle?
Fine. Within the spaceship that I call my house, everything's fine. Just floating around. Nothing else exists. It's just a void out there.
When I look at you, and even in the background of our video call right now, I see Meg the Witch, but I also think about Mog. I think about Owl. I think about Werewolf Jones. These are names of characters that immediately come to mind with the name Simon Hanselmann. What can you say about any of these characters?
Well, they're all cartoon reprobates, of course. They appear in the funny pages, in the modern graphic novels. They enjoy capering and prancing about in a paper theater setting, and they are on Instagram. It's a web-based comic. It's entertainment. It's like a USO show, during these COVID times.
Definitely timely, modern entertainment. Commenting on the bevy of current events seemingly as they happen.
It's me holding up a mirror to society and just chronicling all of this escalation in a fun, colorful way for the kids.
What is the feeling inside you that you have chronicling these events? Do you look on it with a kind of like aloof glee or a very present horror or something else when you translate our world into yours?
It's a mixture. In a way, I feel somewhat detached from events because, I'm in this bubble, this spaceship, this quarantine. So it's seeing history unfold. So I kind of see it in a clinical way, but also it's deeply troubling and, incredibly stressful. I am just staring at paper all day, which is quite nice. I was working on paper with a piece of lead and tube. So that's quite nice to not be in the constant cycle of misery on the social media and just be scratching away like a chicken primally at a piece of paper each day. So that helps keep my mental health in check.
Are any of your characters, especially Meg or the main characters, are they based on you, Simon? Are they a reflection of you yourself?
I think yes, in a way. I mean, all writers, I think, pull from their own experiences. We're all the main characters in our own movies. So I think yes, Werewolf Jones, the Wolfman character, he represents my id, the uncaged, horrendous id. Meg's my feminine side, and Mog is the cold, sort of indifferent side, and Al is the aspirant, crippled with these dreams of something better.
Do you think this is warring parts of your psychology at play?
Yeah, and warring parts of society, different opinions and different schools of thought. It's these reprobate idiots, in their little bubble, just processing everything and, it's a classic, Dickensian tale in a way. It's just all allegories and analogies and, just maybe about a werewolf shoving things up his ass and all this weird shit, but it's deeply, theological and philosophical and all those big words, all of them.
You mentioned it's online, which right now it very much is, but I think it's worth noting that you have a lot of physical media as well that can be found out in the world, including this, Meg and Mog in Amsterdam, a personal favorite of this spelunker.
Indeed, it's a good one. It's an award-winning series. This is a statue for a French statue for the best series for the Meg and the Mog. Amsterdam's a classic title. That was a New York Times bestseller, I believe, for several weeks. Yeah, funny book business is going all right. I don't need no TV. Everyone's like, oh, it needs to be a TV show. I'm like, does it? I don't know if it does. Comics is a fine medium which imbues you with a lot of autonomy as an artist. Very minimal fuckery. So, you know, I rather enjoy that.
When I get very stoned and read the comics, I do feel like I'm seeing them in a cartoon, in moving visuals, which I think is a credit to the consistency of your images, and your characters are always so well depicted. And you just mentioned now, like, maybe no plans for a cartoon, but in an ideal world, would you have that, like, prestige television Meg and Mog cartoon series?
Well, thanks for the compliment about the pacing. See, just very quickly, that's pacing. It's bothering to draw a background like 10 times when a lesser cartoonist would only, they'd lazily just want to do it once. So it just seems stagnant. But if you draw it 10 times, you draw it out, you get that fluid animation type pacing, and the characters really do jump off the page. And regarding television, like, you know, I did just turn down a big TV deal. All year, I've been, oh, fuck, a while now, but, you know, I've been through the ringer with a lot of networks. It's never quite worked out. I got pretty close, but I wasn't writing the scripts, and it got changed. It wasn't Meg and Mog anymore. It was something different, and I was offered money, and I turned it all down, and I just want to do the comics. But, you know, that being said, I'm still talking to numerous people about TV deals. I'm always fingering lots of Hollywood pies. At all times, I have my fingers in a bunch of hot Hollywood pies. But, yeah, no, I'm not going to go to the prom with the first boy that calls me pretty. You don't want to fuck it up. The comic is successful. It's in 13 languages. People like it. Yeah, I don't know. It's nice to just, hey, what... You've got shit on your neck. What? You've turned it. You've got... Have you been spelunking inside?
Oh, that's just... It's
anus.
No. No.
Are they hippies?
No, that's, That's just, crystal meth abuse. Crystal meth abuse, yes.
Okay, that makes sense. Is that what was in that glass saxophone you were just tooting on?
Yes, absolutely. People watching this years and years from now, in whatever dystopian future awaits, what can you give us a quick rundown of 2020? What went wrong? What went right? But overall, what happened?
I don't know if anything's gone right. I mean, what was it? Just, you know, major bat virus. Was it a bat? I think we had a bat virus. And we all thought we were going to turn into bats, but we didn't. We just, a bunch of people got sick. And then everyone got really, really like stressed being stuck in their houses. And everyone was turning into an incel, it seems. Like that's where, you know, everyone was like, oh no, we're all trapped in the house. We're all going to turn into incels. Like, oh shit. So everyone got stressed and ran out of the house and started running around. And then police started just killing people. And everyone got mad, and then it sort of spiraled. And everyone's on Twitter and stuff, everyone's on Yelp, everyone's mad. It's just like a big spider web blowing in the breeze, yeah, a big dirty spider web.
Oh, well, God is a spider.
All the bits are getting snapped. It's a strong breeze. Yeah, 2020, man. The Mayans, didn't they? Isn't that like 2020? Isn't that some like Roland Emmerich action movie with an asteroid and the Mayans were like, it's all gonna end?
That was 2012. That was 8 years ago.
That was 2012.
Yes, but they say that was the soft start to the apocalypse, and we're just in it for the rest of our lives now.
Yeah, no, it's a weird one. We'll be right back.
Ivan, is Instagram real?
No, it's ethereal. It's not physical, it floats in the breeze like dander. Yeah, no, I don't consider it to be real. If the grids went out, boom, it'd be gone. None of it exists. You could smash the server up with a big axe.
So
that's why I like doing all my work on paper, because then it exists. The only thing that can take me down is fire, is the visceral force of nature that's fire, and I own a fucking fire safe. So, I'm fucking invincible.
And your hair looks good, too.
Yeah, it's all shiny. But all these motherfuckers going around doing digital art, putting their hard drives in a pile of rice in the fucking freezer, trying to like, oh, I'm gonna save my work. It's a mug's game. Fools. Foolish fools.
But I notice, color in your images. Do you color them digitally, or do you...
I'm offended that you'd even suggest that any of my work is done digitally.
I'm very sorry.
I'm just joking. I'm just, you know, fooling around. It is all watercolors, colored pencils, cheap shit. I use a lot of food coloring. There's the Queen brand. That's an Australian brand of food color that ladies use for cakes, or anyone. As the Great British Bake Off has shown, as anyone could bake a fucking cake. It's a non-gendered activity. Doing it with the food colors. Cheap colored pencils here. They've got these from the supermarket, from the QFC, the Quality Food Center. It's just a mass market pencil right there. I think that's important so the kids can see that, like, oh, he's just making it with printer paper, you know, computer paper he stole from an office and some other pencils. You don't need tablets. You don't need all that gear. You don't need an education. I dropped out of high school. I'm doing it.
It's valid. No, I think that's valid, and it's good advice, and I think artists should start with physical media and then graduate to digital media.
It's just my opinion as an old school prick and a, you know, egotistical bastard. No, I'm getting distracted again. These holes on your neck, that does not look like meth-induced sores. I know meth. You know, I'm around a lot of meth heads. That looks like some kind of animal bite. I don't know.
Yes, it was an animal bite, but, it was nothing. It happened.
No animal.
There was a dog.
Dog?
Yeah, a large dog, a neighbor's dog. I was, in my backyard, and their dog got loose, and I was bit.
Okay. Are you embarrassed about this fact? I mean, you said it was meth. That's potentially more embarrassing. Okay, move on.
Simon, thank you so much for speaking to these topics today. I think there is a rocky road ahead of us, both in ice cream flavor and just the current events.
I think I could chill out and just read some more, you know, funny books and just, you know, take a breather throughout the day. There's important work to be done. But sometimes you got to do a little bit of hashtag self-care. And you gotta rest, do a quiet poo, and read some Crisis Zone on the Simon Hanselmann Instagram. And that'll be good for what ails you.
Simon, thank you so much for being someone who is giving us these materials to read in the time of the death plague of the 20s.
I live to give, Spelunker. I live to give.
Wait a minute. What really happened to the Spelunker in 2020? What's with all this vampire shit? Who's next on the Habit Cartel's hit list? Find out only on the Smut Cave OnlyFans. Warning, strong sensual content will be observed from every angle. Subscribe now, Smut Cave.
Smut Cave, Smut Cave, Smut Cave, Smut Cave.